Okay. So it's possible that some young people would like to be in my position, to be on the spotlight, on the stage, all eyes on you. People recognize you in the malls and sometimes wherever you go. You might wonder how I got into modeling. So I was a really, really extremely shy little girl, always hiding behind my mom in public. And she saw that as a problem and sent me to modeling school because she thought one of the best ways to boost my confidence was through getting on a runway. Nobody walks shoulders down on their runway. They chin up, shoulders back, and walk fiercely. But I did not just magically complete the course and became 100% confident and comfortable with myself in public. I screwed up my very first runway. I did not make it to the stage. The whole backstage did not only witness me cry, but scream in panic attack. From 1 month to the next, 1 year to the next, even after the course ended, my mom still helped me grow my confidence and overcome my shyness. Until one day, I became a confident girl, or normal at least. At age 13, my mom's friend saw my picture and was eager to introduce me to a modeling agency because she believed that I could be a successful professional model considering my long legs and chiseled facial structure. But I had one obstacle being a model. My paternal grandparents, whom I love and respect very much, they're here today, were against careers involving entertainment. But my parents made a deal with me. As long as I maintained good scores in school, I could pursue modeling. But if my grades dropped, then I would have to stop. It ended up being a great deal for me because I enjoy modeling so much and I do not want to lose it. I studied harder. And my grandparents saw that I could balance both, and finally they agreed that I could do both. So there are some pictures. Okay, next. Yeah, so this was my first photo shoot ever. Not that cute anymore. Yeah, that's enough of the background story. Now let's talk about what young people want. There are three things that some teenagers think are essentials to feel comfortable in the society. First, coolness. Second, popularity and fame. Third, acknowledgement. To receive compliments. But first, let's talk more about coolness. Obviously, you don't want people to see you as a freak, a nerd, or as someone who lacks social skills. That's why some young people tend to follow how their social circle behaves, just so they can somehow be at the same level of coolness and feel they're part of the circle. For example, smoking cigarettes and drinking when you're as a lifestyle when you're not even legal yet. There are some who don't even like to drink, but force themselves to get drunk just so they look cool. Honestly, I just don't get it why. Moreover, to some young people, being polite seems uncool. But in reality, being polite, greeting others politely, and keeping with your great personality, now that is very cool, sexy, and attractive to others. Undiluted coolness, or real coolness, means to have strong values and beliefs, while your actions and what you say confidently expresses these. Sadly, in trying to sound cool, some young people use unpleasant words excessively and unnecessarily in order to blend in. For a young person, to be confident in their values and beliefs, now that is very cool. A young person who can say, no, I'm not going to do that because that goes against my values, really commands the respect of his or her peers, even if they may not necessarily share the same values, but they will see that you have a value that you firmly stand by. I have an example that is a little bit left field. Maybe some of you have heard of the garages in Jakarta that make the same exact copy of supercars like Lamborghini and McLaren, and then bolt them into old Toyota or Honda chassis. Of course, they look like $1 million from the outside, but once you look under the skin, it's a completely different story. That's what fake coolness is like. Something that is equally important is dressing appropriately. You can still look attractive without showing too much skin. Not that showing skin isn't attractive, it really is, I have to admit. But my point is, there's always a dress code for every occasion. Be sexy and classy, not sexy and cheesy. Next is popularity and fame. At this age, most teenagers think that being liked by everyone is so important that that is all they think about. There's the saying, those that matter don't mind, and those that mind don't matter. I'm not saying you shouldn't care about what people think, but it shouldn't take over your life and the way you think. Yes, you should care about what people think, but you shouldn't overthink it. We're social creatures. We need other people to live. That's why we need to care about how people feel and what people feel by what we say and our actions. There are two ways of being liked by people. First, you copycat every single thing they do just to fit in. Or, by expressing yourself, be yourself, express your personality. But of course, there's boundaries to it. There's some things you can do at home and not do in public. Next is fame. Let's be real. Some people are dying to be famous. And again, there's two ways of being it. Negative influence or positive influence. Being famous for a negative influence would be like well-known for doing drugs, you know, drag racing, physical fighting just so you can seem tough. Whereas the positive way is by inspiring others. When you're famous for a positive reason, you have the power to get people listen to you. And obviously you cannot do the same when you're famous for a negative reason. Last but not least, to be acknowledged and complimented. We're humans, we want compliments, we want to feel like we matter. There's no wrong of it. For example, when it comes to Instagram and girls, and it's typical of some girls to comment, oh my gosh, you're so pretty with the heart emojis and all, you know, the heart eyes thing. But in reality, some of them don't even mean it. I cannot stress this enough, but just to say what you really mean is very important, as it is to prevent people being so full of themselves. There's a danger of being complimented rarely. It makes people yearn and thirst for it, always trying to find a way to get people's attention and praise by whatever means possible. Making them feel too validated the moment they're actually being complimented. Though being confident is a must, there's a fine line between being confident and being cocky. Anything in excess is never good. Most important, us to know ourselves, know our weaknesses, know our strengths, so that we know when we're receiving false praise. Everyone has weaknesses. We're humans. Nobody's perfect. That's why we need to learn to accept and embrace our weaknesses. So to wrap this up, I want young people to know, I stand here today as a model. It doesn't mean I'm prettier than you, I'm better looking than you, or I'm any more than you. To be a model, you do not need a good looking face. They look for character and unique faces. So please do not feel like you're any less than models, because you could actually be prettier than them. Secondly, achievement can be in many areas. Doesn't necessarily need to be in entertainment. It just happened I was granted this opportunity. I believe in order to make the world balance, everyone has their own functions and roles in life. Can you imagine if everyone was a model? Who would be watching us, you know? No audience, right? So yeah, and I hope after listening to my personal story, young people start to find their passion and their talent and start developing it. Day by day, week by week, stay focused and it will be fruitful one day. If you ask me when, everyone has their own time. And I believe if you enjoy what you do, you don't compete with time. Rather, just keep doing it. Most important is for us to know ourselves again. Be a person with inner peace. To have principle in life. And who has the guts to say no to negative influence, even if it has to cost us losing friends, because good friends make us better people. Thank you so much. I'm Gaby Hartanto. Have a great, great day.